I have been able to watch tonight's dinner through the prism of a few first-timers, first-time members of the CPJ dinner sitting around us, and it's a useful exercise. This is high season for charity dinners here in New York, and this dinner is really alone among them in offering really graphic violence with your meal. We're all so used to it, we kind of sit and talk through our salad course, and it's arresting. Sometimes we forget the opening montage of people beaten senseless can be a bracing start to the evening. But thank you all, first-timers and non-journalist civilians, for being good sports about it tonight. It's the only dinner of its kind that offers a genuine glimpse of oppression. Point of personal privilege, we at the NBC table are thinking of a lot of folks tonight. We're thinking of our colleague Richard Engel, Richard, along with assorted others with screwed up wiring who want to do what we all want to do, is there with, I saw Ben Wiedemann there last night, just off Tahrir Square, and if you know the confines, you know that if Richard walks out the back door of our bureau, you're then about 150 yards from where the real madness continues to happen at this hour. It does seem like we've just been through it, but in that line of work, of course, at any moment, as we saw, sadly, in Tahrir Square when we were there just this past winter, things could go wrong. And so for us, everyone will take away a different aspect of this dinner. For us as board members, for us as employees and colleagues at NBC News, it's people like Richard we are thinking about tonight. Here we are, two nights from Thanksgiving. There are a whole bunch of our family, our friends, our colleagues overseas doing this work tonight. That's why CPJ is so very real. This isn't a vague organization with an overseas branch that good-hearted people want to support in places like New York City. The work of CPJ is all too real, and of course, it's the executive director who has to deal with all of that, and the staff here in New York, the staff overseas. So we thank them for that. And as my second... There was this moment a few months back, if you watch any NBC News programming at all, you saw it. During the drive to oust Gaddafi, Richard, on one of his days, gallivanting across the desert in Libya, a young insurgent is showing Richard what turns out to be a plastic gun. And during that moment, a rocket comes in from out of nowhere, and Richard dives for cover. If you notice, and if you're in the business, the shot of this scene that ends in this explosion a few meters away remains rock solid, like it's a pedestal camera in a studio. The reason for that is one of our guests here tonight, he was in Istanbul yesterday. I met him, I think, during a search for cold cereal in the middle of the night in our Baghdad bureau. John Cloister, where are you? Combat photographer John Cloister. So points of personal privilege are over. By the way, by being here, you are all missing the latest GOP debate tonight. Importantly for you, they're now at this time of year running hourly. So we're about 29 minutes away from the start of the next one, so that's good. We can all catch one by the time we get home tonight. Our next presenter, as we go about the business of the CPJ dinner, has gone from major stories in, among other places, Central America, the Soviet Union, the Middle East, to leading news operations at Newsweek magazine right before we inherited him as Washington Bureau Chief for NBC News. Earlier this year, he started something new, directing CNN's global news coverage on the air and online, and also this year, he has put out a fascinating book, a tale of his own fascinating journey through life. Ladies and gentlemen, CNN's Executive Vice President and Managing Editor and my friend Mark Whitaker.
Thanks so much, Brian. Mexico boasts a rich and diverse media, ranging from small community newspapers through online news to mega corporations. But in many of them, you will look in vain for probing coverage of Mexico's top story, organized crime. Through a combination of terror and corruption, the drug lords have muzzled the press, or at least much of the press. Tonight, we honor a man who has refused to be intimidated into silence or self-censorship. Javier Valdez Cardenas is a brave man because in Mexico he does something which can get you a bullet in the back of the head at any moment. Report the news. It's my great pleasure to present the 2011 International Press Freedom Award to Javier Valdez Cardenas.
Buenas noches. Muchas gracias al Comité para la Protección de Periodistas por esta distinción que para mí no tiene parangón.
Good evening. Many thanks to CPJ for this distinction, which for me is unparalleled.
He alimentado mi alma enjuta con las expresiones en la calle, abrazos y apretones de mano y palabras en las que me he guarecido. Este premio es la suma añejada y nutritiva de todos esos abrazos. Cuando Carlos Lauría me lo anunció, pensé que era una broma cruel y ahora no quiero que me despierten.
I have nourished my withered soul with expressions in the streets, embraces and handshakes, and words in which I have taken shelter. This award is the finely aged and nutritious sum of all those embraces. When Carlos Lauría informed me, I thought it was a cruel dream, and now I don't want to be woken up.
He sido periodista estos 21 años y nunca antes lo he sufrido y gozado con tanta intensidad ni con tantos peligros.
I have been a journalist these past 21 years and never before have I suffered or enjoyed it this intensely, nor with so many dangers.
En Culiacán, Sinaloa, México, es un peligro estar vivo y hacer periodismo es caminar sobre una invisible línea marcada por los malos que están en el narcotráfico y en el gobierno. Un piso filoso y lleno de explosivos. Esto se vive en casi todo el país. Uno debe cuidarse de todo y de todos. Y no parece haber opciones ni salvación y muchas veces no hay a quien acudir.
In Culiacán, in the state of Sinaloa, Mexico, it is dangerous to be alive, and to do journalism is to tread an invisible line drawn by the bad guys, who are in drug trafficking and in the government, in a field strewn with explosives. This is what most of the country is living through. One must protect oneself from everything and everyone, and there do not seem to be options or salvation, and often there is no one to turn to.
Por eso es importante contar con familia y amigos, periodistas y medios como La Jornada, Diario del que soy corresponsal, y el semanario Río 12 del que soy fundador.
Thus it is important to count on family and friends, journalists and media outlets like the newspaper La Jornada, for which I am a correspondent, and the weekly Río 12, of which I am a founder.
En mis libros, Mis Narco y Los Morros del Narco, de Editorial Aguilar, he contado la tragedia que vive México y que debe avergonzarnos. La niñez recordará esto como un tiempo de guerra. Tiene su ADN tatuado de balas y fusiles y sangre. Y esta es una forma de asesinar el mañana. Somos homicidas de nuestro propio futuro.
In my books, Miss Narco and the Kids of the Drug Trade, I have told of the tragedy Mexico is living, a tragedy that should shame us. The youth will remember this as a time of war. Their DNA is tattooed with bullets and guns and blood, and this is a form of killing tomorrow. We are murderers of our own future.
Esta es una guerra, sí. pero por el control del narco. Pero nosotros, los ciudadanos, ponemos los muertos. Y los gobiernos de México y Estados Unidos, las armas. Y ellos, los encumbrados, invisibles y agazapados, dentro y fuera de los gobiernos, se llevan las ganancias.
This is a war, yes, but one for control by the narcos. But we, the citizens, are providing the deaths, and the Mexican and U.S. governments, the guns. And they, the eminent, invisible, and hidden ones, within and outside of the governments, they take the profits.
Dedico este premio a los periodistas valientes, a niños y jóvenes que viven una muerte lenta. He preferido darle rostro y nombre a las víctimas, retratar este panorama triste y desolador, estos pasos agigantados de tomar atajos hacia el apocalipsis, en lugar de contar los muertos y reducirlos a números.
I dedicate this award to the brave journalists and to the children and youths who are living a slow death. I have preferred to give a face and a name to the victims, to create a portrait of this sad and desolate panorama, these leaps and bounds and shortcuts towards the apocalypse, instead of counting deaths and reducing them to numbers.
Este premio es como un faro de luz del otro lado de la tormenta, un puerto seguro más allá de la tempestad. En Río 12 hemos experimentado una soledad macabra porque nada de lo que publicamos tiene ecos ni seguimiento y esa desolación nos hace más vulnerables.
This award is like a lighthouse on the other side of the storm, a safe harbor beyond the tempest. At Río 12, we have experienced a macabre solitude because nothing we publish has reverberations or follow-up, and that desolation makes us more vulnerable.
Y a pesar de esto, con ustedes, con este premio, puedo decir que tengo donde guarecerme y sentirme menos solo.
Despite all of this, with all of you, and with this award, I can say that I have somewhere to take shelter and to feel less alone.
Muchas gracias.